The natural gas system, very large system, and it's very heterogeneous. It ranges from little well sites or the meter on the side of your house up to giant compressor stations along interstate transmission lines. So the challenge of modeling natural gas, of understanding how it leaks, is really one of a huge range of scales, from many miles to inches, and from little tiny things to really big things. We need to kind of bridge those gaps. Everybody's had experience with natural gas, so you've had it in your house, for your furnace, for your stove, works great. The problem comes when we get a gas accumulation in a confined space. So if it leaks into a basement, into a house, even into an underground manhole cover, then you could have problems. If there's an ignition source, it could be an explosive mixture. The purpose of this facility is to simulate the wind conditions at an oil and gas facility. So a lot of the new leak detection solutions rely on the transport of the emissions downwind. So what we do is we simulate that environment so that the leak detection solution sees the same type of wind pattern that it would see on a real site. So we're doing a couple things to minimize the risks around natural gas. So one of those is to develop new leak detection solutions so that if there is a problem, a leak someplace, you'll detect it sooner. The other part of it is to get those adopted by people. They have to be approved by regulators, adopted by the community. They have to be trusted by everybody. So we're working really on that kind of trust equation. How do you bring regulators, operators, solution providers, and the community together so that we all agree that these things are working?